Hi everyone, and welcome to another one of my vlogs, and one where I eat MunchPak treats at the same time as I talk about what's been going on in my life. I did six of these, last year, I think, and then I decided that was enough. So many of these that I was thinking people would get bored or something like that, so I put my subscription on hold, but now I activated it again, so got six of these lined up, five after this, so stay tuned for those, and let me know what you think about this format again. I guess I was kind of running out of things to say, you know, about each and every candy and snack that's inside, so I'm just gonna be mentioning if something is very good or very bad inside here, but mostly I'm just gonna be talking what's up, basically. First, let's open this up and see what we have here. So this is the August 2019 MunchPak, featuring delicious snacks from Slovenia, Pakistan, Poland, and more. Soda, but I thought I'd try one of these. I saw this in a store here that handles import sodas, and I decided I gotta get this. This is really weird. I had no idea that something like this exists. Cranberry ginger ale. I didn't know that, you know, ginger ale could be some other flavor other than, you know, ginger. But this is cranberry ginger ale. I don't even like cranberry, but let's see how it fares in ginger ale form. So, let's see, of the salty ones we have Disley onion flavored snacks. Salty or sweet, could be anything. It's from Taiwan. And then a couple of these oven fresh banana flavored cupcakes. A Delicia pastry cream. Cookies, Milkolu double milk sandwich. mention this and then I'll mention it again because not everybody watches the same videos, but of course I got engaged. Some of you have seen the ring in my videos. And yeah, life is looking good. If you have been my follower for years, you'll know what happened with the previous one. It wasn't pretty. It wasn't nice, and took me a whole lot of time to get over it and deal with all the angst and suffering that she caused me. But I think that's that after all of that, I can happily say that whatever you're going through life, just keep going, you know, everything will work out, if not sooner, then later, and just keep going, and be yourself, and you'll find somebody who actually appreciates you for what you are, you know, and somebody who is, you know, suitable for you, completes you in the way that you need, yeah, life is good. Weirdest snack I've ever tasted. I still can't quite say if it's salty or sweet. It's kind of neither, and it indeed does taste like egg yolk. It's weird. Some of this ginger ale. Hopefully this doesn't bubble up like the previous one. I can just make some room here. I think we're good. Doesn't taste like ginger ale anymore. It's cranberry soda, basically. But I guess it sells more when you have, you know, big Canada Dry logo and ginger ale says here instead of, you know, wait, who owns this? Was it Coca-Cola company who owns Canada Dry? Well, you know, instead of Coca-Cola or Pepsi, you know, doing some new cranberry soda. Say that it was always easy. I'm just laying, I'm sorry if this is too personal, I'm just laying it all out there. But after something that, after the thing that happened to me in the previous relationship, relationship, yes, it was very hard to trust again, and sometimes it wasn't easy. Sometimes there were conflicts over, you know, the stupidest things. Just keep at it, and you have a partner who is also willing to weather it. It just becomes so much more clear, and you can appreciate things the way they are, instead of, you know, getting them, you know, reflected back of your previous relationship. It's a sum of a million different parts, and but you know, my fiance, she's a gamer, and she loves my son, and my son loves her, and we understand each other, and give each other space when we need it, and comfort. I guess the most important, most important thing in a relationship is how good is, you know, are the normal days, you know, the weekdays, if you will. So not the parties, not the weekends, everything, but you know how the regular life goes on, and that has been so good with us, and we decided to tighten up. Wedding is in a year, actually in a year and a week, something like that, a year and 2 weeks maybe, so getting excited. Let's try a salty one. Free time, I've of course been playing some video games, but I gotta say, at the moment, Warhammer still reigns supreme. I'm sure that I've mentioned this like a year ago in some vlog, but yeah, I'm just so excited about every aspect of the hobby, and it's good that I've been able to play some games more or less regularly. Two other friends who have been playing, and going crazy with it, and you know, talking about, of course, you know, Warhammer is an expensive hobby for sure, and I'd say it's even more expensive now than back when I was a kid, but as a kid I couldn't afford many of the things that were available back then. They were, you know, just doing some summer jobs and all that, couldn't buy you that many miniatures. But you know, getting into the hobby now as an adult with a decent salary and all that, it's just a whole new world. And yet, even though I've put in not an insignificant amount of money into the hobby, it's still, you know, peanuts compared to all of the games that I've bought and the games in my game room. So it's kind of really easy for me to justify buying basically any miniature that I want at the moment that I want it. And still, I feel like I'm saving money when I'm not actively, you know, buying expensive retro games on eBay or something like that. And, you know, basically when you buy a rare one, a rare game that costs like 200 or 300 euros, which is, it's definitely an expensive game, but not even close to one of the most expensive games that I have. But, you know, 200 or 300 euro game, you can, if you buy miniatures with that price, you get, you know, a whole ton of them, and you can get entertained for hours and hours and hours. Whereas, you know, I don't have the time to play all the retro games that I buy. It's mainly for collecting. So many times, if I just buy a retro game, I just put it on my shelf, and I like the fact that it's in my collection, but I don't really play them unless it's something that I've wanted to play since I was a kid, you know. Whereas Warhammer keeps me occupied, I guess, for a lot longer, even when I don't, you know, count in the painting. If I you know, just count the hours that I use to assemble them, and you know, make some new army lists with them, and then, you know, I get to playing with them, that's already a very sizable amount of entertainment that comes out, you know, of a box of 30, 40, 50 euros. If I start painting them, then it's like dozens and dozens of more hours put into them. So long story short, they're expensive, but I don't really view them as expensive, you know, for what they are. They're really detailed, really high quality, and I don't have any problem putting in the money into Warhammer. And sour, really gets your saliva going. It's excellent. So it looks like it's an actual puff pastry. Thank you. previously. We now have a dog. He spins with been with us for a little over a year now. And what can I say? He's a part of the family. I wouldn't have gotten a dog if it was mainly up to me. But my fiance just is such a dog lover that, and she's been wanting one her whole life. So we just had to get it. And of course the little bugger has been growing on me. So it's all good. She is still, you know, as per our agreement, she is still handles all the, you know, takes the dog for a walk and everything, the feeding and everything, so it's still quite easy for me. And of course, my son loves the dog to death, so it's all good. We've been thinking about doing an ASMR eating video with the dog. I'm sure you have seen all of those funny videos where they have the dog in frame and give it some treats and vegetables and stuff like that and see what the dog eats. So, very much like that. But it's just when the dog, he's a corgi, by the way, when the dog eats something, it just sounds so damn delicious, especially when we're cutting his nails, his toenails, and I hold the dog in my lap, so he doesn't flail around, and after each leg finished five nails, my fiance gives a treat to him, and he munches down on the treat, and it just sounds so good. I figured I gotta make an ASMR video out of that. It's probably gonna be a bit short, given how he really doesn't taste anything, just wolfs it down. So whatever we give him, it's gonna take a few seconds to eat. So I guess that's like a 1 minute video maybe, but we'll see. Three items to go. Let's take our second salt. Are good. A lot better than the Doritos. Pretty crunchy. I guess it's about the wheat and the way these are made. sadly, the plans fell through, and I'm not going to Japan this year, but looks like we're going in the spring instead. So, too bad, I would have wanted to go this year, but looks like I'm going next year in the spring, and we're most likely going on our honeymoon to Japan as well. But we'll see. So maybe two trips to Japan next year, I don't know. Trip, and I've never been to Paris Disneyland. I've been to the Anaheim one. I've been to Paris before, but I guess this is gonna be a bit different trip, just me and my son. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.